Hi, my name is Lori Bertoni, and you're watching the Online Prosperity Show, and we're going to be talking about how to love yourself and how to bring the best of you into your business so you can prosper, of course.
Hey. Now, welcome to yet another exciting episode of the Online Prosperity Show, and today we've got the life coach, Lori. Lori, how are you doing, my love?
I'm doing great, Prosper. How are you?
Fantastic. Now, Lori, I've been stalking you for quite a while, and you've got a really intriguing story that would actually help our audiences today. Now, Lori actually helps women to get past their breakthrough and whatever it is that might be holding them back to actually living their passions, their desires, and their dreams. Now, as entrepreneurs, we might be going through a hell of a lot just trying to make our businesses profitable and enjoyable. And then there comes a time when you actually need to talk to somebody who's been through that and has actually got the expertise and the experience to help you out. And that's the reason why we bring people like Lori to actually help you out there. Now, Lori, about passions, about desires, about dreams, why is that important that people should chase any of that instead of sitting on their couch and watching Netflix and eating chips?
Well, you want to have a direction in life, first of all. I think that it's really important to know where it is that you're going. Know where you're coming from. This is where I'm at. I'm Lori, in my basement right now, talking to the awesome Prosper, my future in Australia right now. But where's that going to take my business, right? So I need to know, always looking forward, where I want to go. Maybe a higher income, a better state of health, or just, you know, a destination. I want to travel more. What is it that you see? The big picture vision for your life. Know where you're going.
Understandable. Well, thank you so much. Now, you created a program where you teach people to learn how to fly. Can you walk us through that program and what it entails for people that are, you know, really looking to follow their passions, their dreams, and their desires?
When we look at our business, and you know, it takes a lot of risk, and it takes a lot out of us. It takes a lot of, you know, fears, facing our fears. And when we face our fears, we face a lot of personal blocks. We face a lot of limiting beliefs, and we face a lot of limiting decisions. It doesn't matter who you are, where you're coming from, no matter what stage you are in your life, everybody at some point hits that. I call it next levels, next devils. We're always facing something. But when you have a fantastic relationship with yourself and you know who you are and you're being authentic and you're being genuine in wherever you are, because sometimes we're different people in different circles, you become this, you know, this bird, right? So you become this animal, this eagle, whatever it is, where you get to soar and you really learn to fly. You really get to a level. But that becomes with learning first love yourself. So that's the acronym of FLY. First love yourself. When you know who you are, you respect yourself, you validate yourself, then everything else is gravy because you just keep going and you grind like Prosper does at 9:30 at night. You know what you want and you go for it. So really learning to love yourself, first love yourself, was the program that I created. Really just at the basic foundation to, you know, have a better life and a better business.
Understandable. I really like this acronym, first love yourself. Because we are brought up in this world to actually live a life that we are actually of a happier existence, to learn from our mistakes or mistakes of other people, and then to contribute. But you can't contribute to the greater humanity if you haven't loved yourself first enough to have love to give away. So that's a really powerful foundational subject that you have going on there. Now, early on, we were talking about passions. So you kind of mixed two of your passions, the fitness and also the NLP. And now you are, you know, giving women transformations, especially to those that are actually struggling and feeling stuck with their bodies and in their life. Tell us a little bit about what brought this about, and you know, how you are helping people go through you know, these transformations.
My first phase of my business, I started doing fitness. I love fitness just as a passion myself, and I became a personal trainer, and it was something that I could do with my kids while I was, you know, home taking care of them. And it just grew from there. And I knew that people had blocks in their fitness. And it was like, it didn't matter how many push-ups I made them do or how many, you know, sets and reps and whatever else. They were stuck up here. I knew it was a mindset that was going to break them through. They didn't want to do their food journals. Like, it was just a whole bunch of things. And I'm like, there's a mindset. I'm like, I need more. I need to, what's the next level for them? So when I, you know, started to explore coaching, that's when NLP came into my life, right? And it's just, it just evolved into the mindset. So when I did the NLP and really helped people break through the limiting beliefs that were holding them back, that was the natural transition for me. So now I don't have to stand over people to make them do push-ups. I create a program for them and I hold them accountable in other ways. Also at the same time too, remembering that at the basis of learning to love yourself, fitness is number one. Like, it's like a mandatory almost that you have to at some point in your life realize that you need to move your body on a regular basis for any kind of mental, emotional, or physical health.
Understandable. As business people, we are creating and we have to be relating to the people we're going to be demanding money off of. Now, you can't do well if you actually don't feel well, and you can't give off yourself if you don't have anything or if you're depleted. Now, obviously, a lot of patterns have to be broken for somebody to actually then get into that state of mind of, you know, them being aware that they actually have negative, you know, emotions and limiting beliefs around them that are crippling their success. What sort of, you know, tricks or tips can you give somebody to be a little bit aware, you know, of what might be inhibiting them, especially the fact that it's all unconscious?
Oh my God, that's a perfect question. So in our life, there's 10 areas that we need to, on a daily, not a daily basis, but monthly, you know, two times a year, we need to evaluate. It's our energy, it's our relationships, our mental health, our emotional health, our physical health, our physical universe, our career and business, our prosperity and abundance, and our spiritual health, our spiritual universe, 10 areas. So when something's going awry in your business, right, you have to look and say, where else in my life is the same thing happening? If I'm not getting clients, is it because I don't have, is it because you're not communicating well with them? Is your sales weak? You know, where else in your life are you not communicating effectively? Let's say relationships. Usually business and relationships go hand in hand in the area of the life map that I use to evaluate my clients. So look at your life in other areas. How's your health? How's your fitness? What are you not committing to in other areas of your life that's projecting into your business? Your clients aren't committing to you. Where are you not committed? You know, the money's not coming in. Okay, so where in your life are you not paying money out? Do you owe bills? Like, it's all connected. So whatever you're not getting, what is it that you're not giving out to the universe? If you're not good with your bills, if your prosperity, I think the biggest one energetic tools is money. And when our prosperity and our abundance and our finances are suffering or not showing the big picture vision that we want, then it's time to look at the other areas of our life to see, okay, if this is what we want from our business, what are we not giving to our business? So if we're not fully loving ourselves, and I get that people are like, but I love myself, it's not enough. Like, take really good care of your health. Your energy is super, super important, because if you're not sleeping well, if you're not eating properly, energetically, that's just going to show. You got to take care of your mental health, do lots of affirmations, and, you know, really put out there, put into you what you want to get from your business. So it's a very powerful question, Prosper. And it's, you know, it's not just one thing. There's a lot of things, and you've got to always be looking to improve. And is it a lot of work? And that's exhausting. Yeah, but what do you want? You know, nothing comes easy to those, you know, who want a lot.
Right? Understandable. You did raise a valid point there. We actually do live in a world of duality. There's left, there's right, there's yin, there's yang. You can't expect to get if you're not giving anything out there. So that's the reason why, you know, first you've got to love yourself so that by the time you want to give out, everything else is all in place and stuff like that. Now, all of that, Lori, it takes a lot of motivation. It takes a lot of work, money, time, and effort. It's not a matter of you just sitting here and telling us in one episode that this is, you know, what you're supposed to do and how it works. So you actually inspire and motivate people. So you also created yet another a sequence of programs or a program called Inner Motion Fitness. Is that where all of this then gels in? Because when you now love yourself, you really got to have that motion fitness inside of you to just not be skinny, but to actually be mentally strong.
And Inner Motion Fitness is the name of my very first business. When I created that brand, I wanted it to represent, it's not just about the body. It's not just about exercise. It's not the vanity. It's not the six pack. It's about what moves us not only outside, but inside, because everything starts from the inside out, right? Inner motion. It's all about how do we get moving, that inspiration, that motivation, right? So for me, it was creating, you know, fun fitness programs. It was dance. It was, you know, Zumba. It was, you know, lots of things that kind of masked fitness to make people more more willing to do it, because 85% of the population don't exercise. And if you don't exercise and you want a successful business, get your butt moving. Find something fun. I don't care what it is. Walk, get some tunes pumping. You have to move your body. If you want to move your business, move your body.
That's a really powerful statement right there. I think we can actually call this episode, you want to move your business, move your body. Obviously, like I was asking a little bit earlier on, this just didn't come on its own. You really had to go through some sort of personal growth for you to be able to wake up at 6 a.m. like this and, you know, just talk to strangers and be as vibrant and, you know, help other people to actually have a business that's profitable and enjoyable. How did you, you know, regain your passion again?
Well, fitness for me has always been a passion, and it's funny because I'm not normal, and that's okay, you know. So for me, I've always just found ways to inspire and motivate others to get moving, because it's really important, right? So we already talked about that. But when I went into the coaching aspect, and when I wanted to, that next level for me, obviously I was experiencing my own blocks and limiting beliefs and limiting decisions as a personal trainer, as a coach. And remember, when things aren't working in your business, you got to look at yourself. So when my clients weren't, my first client quit, and if we've got time for a quick story, I'll tell you. My first client quit when personal training, and she hired me, you know, sessions, and two sessions in, she said, Lori, she said, what happens if I get a tight, you know, derriere and my husband's going to walk around and he's going to, you know, want to have sex with me? Is this a family show? You know? And I'm like, oh, how's that a problem? In my head, I was thinking how's that a problem? But I didn't know to ask that. So when I realized that she was having a relationship problem, so after my coaching, right, all that stuff, I was like, wow. But at the same time too, I was having relationship problems. My marriage wasn't going well. And as I sought to seek to fix that, I really just came upon learning to love myself, you know, and it all came hand in hand. So as I went through the program and the coaching, and, you know, I was coaching myself, right? So those blocks were coming into my life as a sign to be like, hey, you've got something over here that needs your attention in your relationships. So I sought to improve that. And unfortunately, my marriage didn't make it. But through all that, I learned so much about myself and what I deserved and what I needed and wanted. And so many people don't know what they need and they want in so many areas of their life that the universe just kind of gives you whatever. So you need to get really, really clear about what it is that you need and you want in your personal life and in your business. And you'll see that they're pretty much, you know, they go hand in hand. So you really knowing who you are and what you want at a core level, really, you have to have that solid foundation for any success in your life.
Thank you so much for sharing that story with us. And obviously, we might have people in the audience right now that, you know, sitting at the edge of their seat going, oh, she is such a brave lady. Now, Lori is on a mission to actually share the exact tools that, you know, she got herself through those tough times that she's talking about in her life and got herself back on top of her game where she is today. And congratulations for that. Some people would have just stayed down there and wouldn't have heard all this awesomeness coming up. Now, if somebody's watching this and they're a lady that is going through some sort of conundrum in their life, in their business, money, or whatever it is that you can help them, how can people get a hold of you there, Lori?
You can email me at info@loribertoni.com. That's probably the best way, considering the time zones are really, really different. You can send me a Facebook message, and I would definitely love to connect with you to, you know, to give you some tips and tools. But the first thing I want to say is good for you for recognizing that you may or may not have a problem in your life. And, you know, it takes a lot of courage to even just consider, oh my God, I need to get to talk to somebody about this, and you're doing the best that you can. So just, you know, keep seeking. You're going to get the answer you want. You're just going to have to keep going through all, you know, the trials and tribulations of finding it, but it's coming. So if you're looking for it, it's coming. So good for you.
Thank you so much for, you know, opening up communications channels with yourself there. And you might also be very helpful for those that are probably in Australia and they're still, you know, sitting up late at night. It will be morning for you, so it would actually work out, you know, perfectly with the time zones, like you're saying there. Okay. Now, you know, Lori talks about first loving yourself and, you know, having, you know, inner motion fitness. There's a lot of things that we could pack into this episode, but obviously we can only do so much. But as we have noticed, Lori has been through a lot herself, but she continues to actually shine her light on people so she can brighten their way and highlight all of their magnificence. Everybody is important and special in their own way. And especially if you're a business person that is going through something, remember your life story and your experience have greater commercial value. And we really want that your business is profitable and enjoyable. And people like Lori are going to be showing up in your life. Maybe you have called them. You never know how the universe works. And she knows that everyone has what it takes to live a more fulfilling and satisfying life. And if this is what you are going to be doing for yourself, as she has said, kudos to you. All right. Now, Lori, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much for having me. It was awesome.
Yeah, I hope you enjoyed being on this show, and thank you so much for the value that you just dropped in for us there.
You're welcome. You're very welcome.
Great stuff. All right, so that's the recording side of things. How do you think we went?
It was awesome. It was awesome. I'm listening to you, you know, just give the information that I have out there. And I'm like, wow, that's great stuff. I'm like, wow, I love that. You know, I'm like, is that me? He's talking about me. I'm like, that's really great. It's very affirming. A lot of validation there. It's great.